Mighty Mac. It was summertime on the island of Sodor. Lots of vacationers were coming to the island. They liked to see the beautiful forests and the high mountains. It was a busy time for all the engines. A new engine had arrived on the island. He was going to help take the vacationers up into the mountains. Thomas had arrived at the transfer yards. He was very excited to meet the new engine. "Hello," puffed Thomas.
"Hello," the new engine puffed back. "I'm Mighty."
"And I'm Mac."
"And together, we're Mighty Mac," they whistled happily. Thomas had never seen such an unusual engine before. Then the narrow gauge controller, Mr. Percival, arrived.
"Mighty Mac, you are to take some vacationers to the mountain campground," said Mr. Percival.
Mighty Mac could see the vacationers. They were waiting on the platform. But there were lots of tracks between Mighty Mac and the vacationers. Mighty Mac didn't know how to get to the platform.
"We've always worked in the shunting yard," moaned Mighty to Thomas.
"How will we find our way over to the passengers?" groaned Mac.
"It's simple," whistled Thomas. "Look at where you want to go, then follow the track that will take you there." Mighty set off nervously. But as they puffed along the track, Mac thought his way was quicker.
"This way,"
he said.
"No, Mac," puffed Mighty. "It's this way."
Soon they were puffing left and right, backwards and forwards. They were very confused. They even had a ride on the turntable. Then, at last...
"We're here," puffed Mac.
"Then why are the vacationers over there?" asked Mighty.
"Because you didn't look where you wanted to go. You didn't follow the right track," said Mr. Percival sternly. "Now you're late."
"Sorry," said Mac.
"Sorry," said Mighty.
They felt very silly. Finally, the passengers were on board. Mighty Mac puffed through the countryside on the way to the campground.
"We have to get there before dark," chuffed Mighty. "So we'll have to work extra hard."
Then, in the mountains, there was a fork in the track. Mighty wanted to go left.
"This way," he puffed.
"No! Go the other way," shouted Mac.
But Mighty was already pulling them past the fork. Mac was cross. The next time they came to a fork in the track, Mac wanted to go the other way again.
"This way,"
he puffed. And he pulled Mighty back to the junction and then pushed him back up the other line. Now, Mighty was cross. They puffed through the mountains, and whenever they came across a junction, Mighty would push one way, then Mac would pull the other. The vacationers were having a very bumpy ride. They spilt their drinks, and their donuts went flying. But Mighty Mac pressed on. Then there was trouble. They had arrived at a dead end. The vacationers took a look around.
"This isn't the campground," said one of them.
"It's not even a nice place for our picnic," said another.
"This is your fault," puffed Mighty, and he pushed back towards Mac.
"Yours," huffed Mac, and he pushed back even harder.
The vacationers watched as Mighty Mac bumped backwards and forwards.
"Stop!" called the vacationers. "You're going to cause an accident."
But it was too late. Mighty pushed Mac as hard as he could, and the coach crashed into the rocks. First, one rock fell, then another rock. Soon, lots of rocks came tumbling down.
The track was blocked, and they were all stuck.
We'll never get to the campground now, moaned the vacationers.
And it was all Mighty Mac's fault. They felt terrible. It was getting late. The vacationers were working hard. They were trying to get the coach back onto the rails. Then, with a mighty heave, the vacationers lifted the coach back onto the track. Mighty Mac was watching them.
When the vacationers worked together, hooted Mighty.
They lifted the heavy carriage onto the track, tooted Mac.
Then they had an idea.
If we both work together, puffed Mighty.
We'll be strong enough to push those rocks out of the way, huffed Mac.
So Mighty Mac rolled up to the rocks and pushed and pushed. The rocks rumbled, and then they rocked until finally the track was clear. The vacationers cheered. Mighty Mac was ready to go. They could see the flag flying high above the campground. Then they remembered what Thomas had said.
Look where you want to go, Puff Mac.
Then follow the track that will take you there, Chuff Mighty. Off we go,
they whistled together. Mighty Mac puffed up the mountains. And soon, they arrived at the campground. The vacationers were very happy, and Mighty Mac was very proud.
You know, Mac, wheezed Mighty, when we pull together and work together,
we can be a very useful engine, whistled Mac.
And they set off happily back down the mountain.